The application deadline for the Brooke Owens Fellowship is coming up soon, and whether this is your first time hearing of the program, you've been considering applying, or you're in the process of creating your application, we're here to give some last-minute encouragement. The Brooke Owens Fellowship is an opportunity for undergraduate women and gender minority students interested in aerospace to receive a paid internship and executive mentorship. Brookies get the opportunity to intern at some of the leading aerospace companies across the country and get mentored by astronauts, CEOs, and lead engineers. We know applying can be challenging and intimidating to say the least, so we decided to reach out to some current Brookies to learn more about their fears while applying and any advice they have. I hope you enjoy.
Hi everyone, my name is Anna Volker.
My name is Luke Riesbeck.
I'm Ricky, Ricky Roy.
So my name is Hannah Mugia.
My name is Michaela Dunn, I also go by Mick.
My name is Shannon Gatta.
My name's Maureen.
Angelica Berner.
So I'm Megan Cambrough, but I go by Megs.
I kind of applied to the Brooke Owens Fellowship at that point from ground zero. Like I had failed two classes at that point, I had used freshman forgiveness. I knew what failing felt like for the first time, and it's almost like I didn't have anything to lose, and I just really wanted that opportunity as an international student.
My biggest uncertainty was, I don't do aerospace. You know, I'm not an engineer. I talk to kids about planets. I was like, this doesn't sound like it's for me. And so I actually, I had heard about the application, I was very interested, but I kind of put it off because I wasn't sure if I really met the requirements until, wouldn't you know it, it's the day it's due. And I don't even know how I found it, but I found Will's phone number, which I don't even know where I got it, but I called him out of the blue. He didn't know me at all. And I was like, one, am I eligible? And two, exactly what time and time zone do you need my application submitted in?
Of course, imposter syndrome is always going to be there. And when you look at the lists of women that are in Brooke Owens, it's like they have these incredible resumes of just Harvard, Yale, and they've done all these amazing projects and worked in places like SpaceX. And it's just like, how am I special? I'm literally just came from a community college.
No, I mean, I'll be honest. I waited until like 2 days before the application was due to do it because I didn't think I could get it, but that's false, right? Because I got it. It's also really hard to hear no, because I've heard no from this fellowship too.
I feel like I was the only one. I was like, everyone else is gonna get it like first try. But yeah, so you probably like feel me on this where, you know, just because I didn't get it the first time, the second time around, I was like, okay, what can I change? I took all that whole year from not getting it to be like, how can I get more involved? How can I show like what I'm worth, what I can give, what, you know, I'm passionate about?
2017, 2018, I was not confident in myself at all, my skills or abilities or knowledge. And I would say that it was just intimidating overall. Seeing the people who did make it in the 2017, 2018 classes, and then looking at myself and looking at the fact that I had zero to no experience. I had a lower GPA than most people I knew, you know, and also just being a minority and looking as though, or feeling as though I had to prove something about myself to people. I feel like that put a lot of pressure on me unknowingly, which caused me not to apply. But with the encouragement of my advisor and my parents in 2019, we were like, okay, we're just gonna go ahead and apply. We're gonna wish for the best, you know, we're gonna just put your best foot out there, just show your passion, because I think that was really what was most important, was saying, you know, yes, I don't have these high GPAs, I don't have these tons of extracurricular activities under my belt, I don't have an internship under my belt, but I do have passion. And I feel like that really made a difference in who I was and who I became as an engineer.
I said earlier, I think the main thing is just to go for it and to not count yourself out, because I think that's such a common problem, is people counting themselves out, you know, before they even get the chance, like taking the chance away from themselves.
You really just can't hesitate about this. This will be one of the most important things that you're a part of if you want a career in aerospace.
Be unapologetically yourself in your application, and don't be worried about trying to come off as someone that you think the fellowship wants or something like that. Just be yourself and show your true self and really express your passion. And I think that's the best way to present yourself.
So that's something I definitely also say, if there's anyone out there listening who doesn't identify as a woman, but is still, you know, a gender minority within the field, this is a place for you. This is somewhere you're welcome.
Going with your gut and not getting too scared to just not press submit, you know? That was really, I think that's really the rough part, just the beginning, the middle, and the end. Once you all get it all together, you're like, okay, you know, I have everything. I don't know if it's great, but I'm gonna send it in anyway.
Especially if you're someone like me who might not be a traditional, you know, aerospace engineering student and might not be sure if you fit, you do.
You can be interested in anything and then plus aerospace.
So don't second guess yourself if you don't have like a traditional space degree, or if you have struggled with your GPA, or if you, you know, any number of factors that you are like thinking will make you less competitive. The Brooke Owens Fellowship isn't about getting the top 2% of a graduating class into the fellowship. That's just not really the point. We are much more focused on like bright, creative individuals.
Be analytical about addressing the fears that you have in your head. Write down all your fears on a piece of paper. Write down what is holding you back. Write down all the things you don't know, and send them to Ask a Brookie, our platform on the Brooke Owens Fellowship page.
Best piece of advice I have would be to take the opportunity to apply. Work past the discomfort and work towards the vulnerability. And it's hard, it's really hard. And it's hard hearing a yes or a no. And it's scary, you know? We shouldn't downplay that. It is scary, but it's also okay. And there's a really great community behind it. And I know we have like a Slack channel for applicants to support each other. And one of my favorite things about the fellowship is that when you're applying, even if you don't get it, you usually come out of it learning something about yourself.